because, like I said, man. Hallelujah. Amen. The one that carried the seed. We incubate it. But the one that carried it. Hallelujah. If you see him on the street, you say, oh, you boy. He's a young man. He's an army. The first time I come in contact with him was on Facebook through some of my mommies. And because his name looked familiar from where I come from, I decided to friend him. Until then, I started seeing great things and I was impressed. But one way or the other, I was able to be under his administration. Well, I was one of. Praise God. I was blown up not because of him, because it comes to my understanding that it is not a man thing. It's Jesus said that this has not been revealed to you by flesh and blood. It has been revealed by the Spirit of God, because he's a young man. There's so many things here. But I'm just talking, if I start analyzing it, I think he will not have time to minister to you. I want you to enjoy it, you know, but prepare your heart. You have been blessed so much that now let the Lord crown it for you. Don't get tired, because there is nothing to be tired about. When the day he talked about a woman, I now look at him again. Is he a man? He described us, and I just, my prayer every time is, if men can go under his administration, I think there will be a reposition, like our mommy said, in families. And I will not talk much, because the Lord himself will reveal his word in his life. There's no other prophet. Oscar Gwabazi.
Are you excited?
Yes.
I try not to look like a young man with my beard. Amen. I want to thank God for this privilege to stand before wonderful women of God.
Amen.
Blessed are our mom's women. I'm grateful to the men of God as well. Our mom is in the house. Thank you so very much. Thank you, woman of God, for this privilege. This is actually the first ministration after the wedding. So, hallelujah. Thank you. It's been awesome. You know, from the very beginning, it's been wonderful. And I thank these great verses. God bless you. God bless you. One of the things that the Lord was doing in my heart when I was there, the Lord was saying to me, well, a couple of things actually. But one of the things the Lord said, I think they all reiterated it, is the word release. Amen. God wants to release into you, for you, for the world. Are you listening? God wants to release into you, for you, for the world. Praise God. And I want to thank God for this great opportunity. God bless you. I'm the last speaker, I'm sure. Good. I'm not going to take your time, trust me. I'm just going to be quick, and we'll go. Father, we thank you for your word. Bless our hearts in Jesus' name. Ladies of Impact, when I was coming this morning from home, I was asking the Lord, why Ladies of Impact? You know, the same questions, you know, you kept asking God, why Ladies of Impact? And I found out that the word impact, well, I'm not good with English, so don't mind me, and impact is a response from an action. Amen. You know, back in secondary school, we did Newton's third law that says that action and reaction are equal and opposite. So the word impact is a response from an action. So something must have happened for an impact. Amen.
Yes.
And each time I find myself speaking in a women's conference, I feel very grateful and honored because of a revelation or the revelatory insight the Lord has given me about women, for women. And a lot of times I ask people, what was the last of God's creation? And they tell you God created a man. But that's not true. The last of God's creation was the woman.
Yeah.
Amen. Because why God created the man, you think is the last. God had to kill the man separately to create a woman from the man. So she is the seal of creation. Praise God. She is the seal of creation. If the church of God can get it right, the place of a woman in the church, the society will get it right. A dysfunctional woman leads a dysfunctional home. And a dysfunctional home births a dysfunctional children. And dysfunctional children become dysfunctional in the community. Praise God. But if a church can empower its women or our women, then the home will be empowered. And when the home is empowered, the community is empowered. Praise God. But one of the things that happen in this society, we have some set of Christians, politically, I will be theological, a set of Christians who call themselves very reformed in their effort to tell you, because you're a woman, you can't preach. Because you're a woman, you can't teach. Because you're a woman, you can't do this and do that. Why? Because of their lean understanding of God. I call them Antichrist, with all due respect. When they begin to relegate you, listen, to understand the church, you must understand the woman. Let me treat Genesis 1, 2, 3, right? Bible says in creation, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God began to move upon the face of the waters, and God said in the light, and there was light. And it went on, God said it was good. Everything God created was good. Was
good.
Everything God created was good. Praise God. And the Bible says that God said, let us make man in our own image. Not by the word man, I'm going to give you a difference between a man and a male. A man is different from a male. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
God said, let us make man in our own image, just in our likeness. And that God created a man. But the Bible says something. The Bible says God saw that it was very good. And most of the time, when we study scripture, maybe because I'm a bit of a theologian, I try to go in there. Now, before God gave man what you call the Adamic covenant, God gave man the Edenic covenant. And the Edenic covenant was to be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth, subdue, replenish. Amen. These were the Edenic covenant given to man. And when I mean man, I mean the Spirit of God in a dust. Now, take what the Bible says, God created or God formed man from the dust. Now, the word dust in the Greek or in the Hebrew etymology is called Adam. So, Adam means the dust from the ground. So, God created man from the ground. And man had no life. Now, even though he had lungs, man had no life. Even though he had intestines, man had no life. Even though he had heart, man had no life. The Bible says, until God bred his DNA into the dust, and the dust became a man. Take note that even though God created the dust from the ground, it was lifeless. What gave life to the dust was the breath of God. And when the breath of God came upon the dust, two things happened. A Zoe, which is the Spirit of God, made man alive. Man became a Zao. Z-A-O means to be alive. Z-O-E means the Spirit of God in the dust. Are you following me? So man was conscious. Man became alive. He had God's Spirit and he became alive. Praise the Lord. At this time, the woman was not created. And I tell you a lot of times, three combinations that the Lord gave man that the devil will fight in this age. Number one, when God created the man, God said to the man, dress and keep this garden. The second covenant was marriage. The third covenant was Sabbath. These things were orchestrated and designed before the fall of man in chapter 3. And the devil will fight your marriage.
Yes.
He will fight your Sabbath, your resting on him.
Yes.
And he will fight the work of your hands. Praise God. See what happened. Now the devil came to the garden and the devil said to the man or to the woman, did the Lord say that? Now before she was created, let's talk about the man. Now, the man was a spirit, or the man is a spirit that has a soul that lives in the body. Now this spirit was in the garden, having fellowship with God. Now, God will not communicate with your body. He doesn't communicate with your soul. He communicates with your spirit, because your spirit is God conscious, your soul is self conscious, and your body is world conscious. So, God created man from the dust of the earth, and God bred his DNA into man, and man became God. So, what is a man? A man is the Zoe of God. What is a male? A male is the dust of the earth.
Yes.
Are you following me?
Yes.
So we have so many men with testicles in the world today. So many men who all they do is pregnant women. They are not men, they are males. Are you following me?
Yes.
And that comes to the church of God as well. Why you have no spirit of God in the church, we don't have it as the church of God, as man, but as male. The Bible says when Christ went to the temple, he never went back to the temple to start saying, let me increase the anointing in this temple. The Bible says he went to the temple and overturned tables. Why? Because the temple was actually a dust without the spirit. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the Lord eventually said something that is very unscriptural, but scriptural, but it doesn't make sense logically. The Lord said everything that the Lord had created was what? But the first time the Lord said it was not good. It is not good that the man be alone. The last time I checked, I thought he said it was very good. But this time, it is not good that the man be alone. You know, with all the respect to women here, those of you who know me, I'm a very controversial young man. Well, I'm not fought them, if they are fighting these men of God we have in the UK. I will speak the truth. If you don't like it, don't invite me anymore. And whenever you invite me two times to the church, I tell them I'm honored. Because when I preach for the first time, you might not invite me again. Now, what happens? Bible says it was not good that the man be alone, make for him or helpmate. Unfortunately, with all the respect to women and the ministries, unfortunately, what we have in this day and age that you call inspirational women's meeting, empowering women's meeting, and all that, most of these things are not really the will of God. And with all the respect to your cause and to your ministry, most of the time, you are being empowered to be independent. Most of the time, you're being empowered to be like your husband. Most of the time, you're being empowered to even become the breadwinner of the house or the head of the house. Are you following me? It is very dysfunctional, ladies and gentlemen. In the mind of God, the woman was not created like the man. The man was created from the dust of the earth. The woman was not created from the dust of the earth. Take note. When God created Adam from the dust of the earth, God breathed his DNA into Adam and Adam became alive. So the first product into the dust was the life of God. Now when God was to create the woman, God did not go back to the earth to create the woman. She was not created from the dust of the earth. She was created from the regenerated man. So she was not created from Adam. She was created from Adam. See how you demote yourself when you try to be like a man? She was not created from the physical dust of the earth. Everything God has created, that God created the heavens, the celestial beings, everything was literal, physical. But God did not create the woman from the physical dust of the earth. God had to kill the woman. Before God killed the man, by the way, God had to make the woman from the spirit of God in a man. So the woman was not created from the dust of the earth like the man, but she was created from the life of God in the man. So by virtue of creation, she is the spirit by default. Are you following me? She's a spirit by default. She points to God. She wants to meet God. She wants to intercede with God. Well, this is why you find many women in churches, by the way, because they are naturally into spiritual things. Even the good and the bad. So that is the woman for you. But see what happened. But I would say, before the woman was created, like I told you, for you to understand the word church. Church is a Greek word for the word ecclesia. Ecclesia means all that ones. For you to understand the word church, you must understand the word woman. For God to create the woman, God had to kill the man. Ask me where did Adam die, though. Adam had to die temporarily. Praise God. I would say, the Lord made the man fall a deep sleep. And from the sight of man, the Lord God took out an operation, you know, went to the theater. I said, Adam, because you don't have a womb, now I'm going to take it from your side. So the first birthing in the body was not Cain and Abel. The first birthing in the body was the man who gave birth to his wife.
That's the reason why it is an error for you to have a spiritual father as a man and a woman. It is an error for you to have a spiritual father that your husband do not know of. I tell them, I'm young in marriage. I tell them, any woman who says hello to me, say hello to my wife as well. You have to. I've seen. Hello. Wow. Young man, you look good. You're tall. 6 foot. Wow. Are you a prophet? Wow. The Lord calls for the follow this, the Lord created the woman from the man. And the Bible says when Adam woke up, Adam said, this is what now. I'm not in the scripture now. This is now. Bone of my bone. And flesh of my flesh. Now the word now in that context, it means that we were all fast before. Why would Adam wake up from his sleep and say, this is now? Does that mean that God was giving him all fast? Bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of me. She was taken out of me, she shall be called man. Now guess what? The Bible said, the Lord said, it is not good that the man be alone. What the Lord read in Genesis chapter 2 from verse 6 downward, the Bible said, the Lord created the fish of the sea. And the fish of the sea came to Adam. And God said to Adam, you want to make this fish your wife? The breath of the air? Genesis 2:19. See there, it's in the Bible. Now, one of the things you need to understand in scripture. When God created the man, Bible never said God made a help meet for the man alone. Bible says that God said man needed a helper or a help meet that is comparable to him.
Yes.
Praise God. Yes. So when God created the fish of the sea, the fish of the sea could be helpers but not comparable. The ostriches could be helpers but not comparable. Yes. You know, the animals could be helpers but not comparable. Adam was saying to God, no, I do not want this time. And Lord said, now you don't want this time. Now you need to sleep for me to create the next one. Now God said, and the Lord took from the side of man and God created the woman. Now, the reason why I've taken time to let you know this is this. You as women, with all respect to the men, I'll come back to you in a minute. You as women, you are by default spirits. Can you follow me? If women can hold hands together and pray for relation, the problem with women is that whenever you gather, all you do is have to be better than your husbands. It is a dysfunctional, it is out of God, it is not the mind of God. God never created you to be better than your man. Let me want help me. Now when God created everything, God said it was good. Why did God say it is not good this time? All everyone was created for was just an assignment. Listen. We know people tell you, you can do this and do that. You are created for just one assignment. And the assignment is to help him meet. Help him meet. She was the last to be created because she was the seal of God's creation. Just as the Holy Spirit is the seal of the church. And the Holy Spirit is called our helper. Help the church meet. Have a comforter. Help us meet. Praise God. The question you need to ask yourself this day is this. Are you really a woman of impact? Impact is a response. What is your action? Mark chapter 10. Mark, I'll be very quick. Mark chapter 10. Matthew was written to the Jews. Mark was written to the Gentiles. Luke was written to the Romans and John to the church. Praise God. I thank God for your life as well. Tell the Lord of time, there are dispensations, time has passed. I believe in the prophetic. Now, prophecy is not just prediction, it's a pattern. It's not, I won't call names. So if you, those who know me, if you are waiting for names today, sorry, no names. The Lord is not giving me any names. No, I'm not calling names today. Yeah, so don't worry about that. Sorry, I said that when I traveled last time, I was saying to them, with all due respect, I'm not calling names today. All I heard was, hey. No names today, sorry. Verse 46. There is a woman, Auntie, the very first speaker, sorry, the very first speaker, yeah. There's a woman who's going to come to you. I don't know when, I don't know how, but she'll come to you because her daughter is asthmatic. Yeah, but I can tell, I don't know. But I'll bring like a tube. It's grey blue. A tube. And this tube, I don't know what you're gonna put in the tube. Yeah, I don't know what you mix. You know, I saw you doing your mixing now. You do whatever you put in the tube. And you give to this woman. And this woman will take it back to her child. And she will administer to her child. And she will get that instant healing. But guess what? That's not the end. That's not where it's going. She will not just get that healing, get her heart healing. It will become a system, a pattern. The Lord is not calling you to be a medic, whatever, I don't know what you call yourself. The Lord is calling you to, Bible says, I hear the word, is there no bound in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is the health of the daughter of my people not recovered? The Lord is saying that this evening is calling you out in this season, that you shall begin to administer with your skill divine healing that is physical. I'm not talking about spiritual, but divine healing. People will come with their sicknesses. And all you need to be just administer the word bound. Is there no bound in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is the health of the daughter of my people not recovered? Bible says from verse 46. Are you there?
Yes.
Are you there? Guide the camp to Jericho. I don't like seeing the word Jericho in the Bible. I don't like it. For some reason, I don't like Jericho at all. The last time we saw Jericho was in Joshua. And Jericho was boom. Fell down on the floor. I don't understand why it's coming up in any dispensation. I don't like it. And it was even cursed. I don't know who gets Jericho again. Shall be cursed. Even though some guys tried to beat it, they were cursed. So Jericho's nothing good. The last time we saw Jericho, Jericho was the barrier between your wilderness and your promise. Jericho was the distance between where you are, looking around Kadesh Barnea, to your promised land that flows with milk and honey. So whenever you see Jericho, it's a stumbling block. I don't like it. You know, Christ will always say something to his disciples, let us cross over to the other side. You know, Jericho is actually, it's a tall fence, you know, that barricaded the Israelites from their promise. And all they did was to wander around Kadesh Barnea. What Kadesh Barnea means, holy wandering. They got Christian, but they were wandering. Holy wandering. I'm a Christian, but I'm broke. I told you I'm Christian, you can be broke. Holy wandering. I was saying to people a few days ago, if not for Joseph of Arimathea, what would have happened to the body of Jesus? No, if I didn't come out to say, I'm a rich guy, I put my pride too. What would have happened to the body of Jesus? He had a one-to-one with Pilate. I'm a big boy. And those of you professing prophets of nations, I'm pastors and apostles of nations, you cannot be prophets of a nation if you don't know the laws of the nation. So before you start professing, I'm a prophetic person called to the nations, you must know the laws of that nation. If you are called as a prophet and an apostle of the marketplace, you must understand marketing, you must understand global relationship, you must understand. Listen, someone was saying to me, why do you have to pack degrees and degrees? I cannot stand before you and teach you what I don't practice. How can you stand before me and tell me about divine about kingdom prosperity and your shoes are bent? Who does that? Why don't you live what you preach? So they stood before, Bible says, they came to Jericho. But see what it says. As Jesus and his disciples, and they came to Jericho, as Jesus and his disciples together with a large crowd, we are leaving the city. Notice something. They came to Jericho, but they were leaving Jericho. There was no mention of Jericho. Even Jesus could not stay in Jericho. Because it was a mess. They came to Jericho. It was just a reference point to where we were going. They came to Jericho. Christ did not even stay in Jericho himself and the disciples. They began to go out of Jericho. Because Jericho doesn't make sense to you as a believer. Amen. So if you are a believer and you are in Jericho, trust me, you must fall your wall tonight. You can't be in Jericho as a believer. So they came to Jericho, there was no event in Jericho, even though it was mentioned. Bible says Christ passed Jericho with the disciples. The Bible says a blind man, Bartimaeus, who is the son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside begging. Now take note, they came from wherever they were coming from the previous verses, into Jericho, and a blind man, the reason why Jericho was mentioned in Jesus' reference was because of a blind man called Bartimaeus. The word Bartimaeus is the son of Timaeus. Bar in the Aramaic word means son, and Timaeus means, or Timao means honor. So he was called the son of honor, even a son to the son of honor. Praise God. But the Bible says something, he was the son of honor, but he was in Jericho. That looks like me a few years ago. My name is Gobadia, means I dine with the king. But life in the UK was not like I was from the royal home. Things seemed like I was lost. There was nothing coming for me. I was in Jericho, even though I had kinship to my name. Are you following me tonight? Listen, if you can give me just a few minutes of your time, I believe me this way. I won't tell you like, believe me, God will set you free in the name of Jesus. He was in Jericho, the son of honor. And it was not just in Jericho. How can you be a son of honor? You are in a deserted place, begging. God has called some of you out of darkness into his marvelous life, and you are still in your Jericho, begging. What could be worse than the son of honor? What could be worse than a king's son? What could be worse than someone who is royalty by a deserted place, begging? He has no choice in Jericho. Listen, the distance between your Jericho and your promise is a leap of faith. Are you following me? If you can just take your leap of faith to the next level, God is giving you your land that flows with milk and honey. I need a church. God is giving you a land that flows with milk and honey. The Bible says he was begging. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout. Hearing and hearing by the word of the Lord. Listen, I tell people, wherever you are, do not stop shouting the name of Jesus. Wherever you are, somebody needs to hear that word, Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 16 that Paul and Silas were put in prison. Why were they put in prison? The Bible says at midnight they began to sing praises of psalms to the Lord, and the prisoners heard them. Jesus was not his sight because he had lost his sight anyway, so he had ears to hear.
Yes.
He heard Jesus.
Yes.
He heard Jesus. Listen, somebody, listen to me. This is prophetic now. Your name that has never rang the bell before, the word we hear of you. In the name of Jesus. Do you know what I'm saying? That my Bible tells me in Genesis there was a man called Joseph who was loved by his father made him a coat of many colors. What does it mean to have a coat of many colors? It means that a coat is a garment. It covers your age, it covers your status, it covers your qualification, and it has so many colors. It was not black and white, it had green, purple, gray, red, orange. It has all the colors, but it's brought by the angels of him. First thing first, they put him in the pit. Next thing, they put him to the Potiphar's house. And next thing, he was put in prison. Ask for a question. At every point of his being put in the pit, Potiphar, prison, there was a change of garments. Even when he had to go to the house of Potiphar, she took his garment because she wanted to live with him. Took his garments. Why? He went to the prison, they gave him a prisoner's garment. Do you know why life was unfair to him? If you read your Bible, the Bible says he was put in the king's prison. He was not put in a commoner's prison, he was put in a king's prison. Sometimes God will put you in a king's prison so that the Bible says that while he was there, the Bible says suddenly someone remembered him in the prison. And they said to Pharaoh, we know this young man who is very gifted. And this man said that in the old Jewish or in the old Egyptian dispensation, you do not stand before a king as a prisoner. Rather than a prisoner's regalia rather. And guess what? They have to change his garment again.
Amen.
But the reason why his garment was changed for the coat of many colors, the God must never bring yesterday into today's journey. Tell your neighbor, let go.
Let go.
And let God.
Let go.
Bible says, blind Bartimaeus, he heard. Faith comes by hearing. As he heard Jesus, his faith was beginning to stir up. The rich man said, of you are where you are depressed and look like life has ended because there's little of Jesus in your household. You cannot start your morning with Beyoncé and expect to have a productive day. Well, even though pastors have been the worship leaders in church. Bible says, when he heard it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout. He did not cry, he began to shout. Bible says, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Praise God. Anyone who called Jesus Son of David knows he is the Messiah.
Yes.
He was blind, but he knew. Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. You never said, Jesus, Son of David, come heal my blindness. He said, have mercy on me. Sometimes you don't know where the sin has come from. But mercy is a blanket prayer. Have mercy on me, covers my mess. Praise God. Then the Bible went on to say something very profound. Many beauty. How wicked can the world be? You see a man whose life is hopeless, in Jericho, blind, begging, yet you see the beauty. Is it not, does not happen in church? It's your small kid that you have people there to shut up. You tell you to shut up. You think you're the one who prays more, huh? What she shared with us now, it was what happened in the old, in the New Testament when Paul, when Peter, when the church was about to be birthed, the Bible said, and began to speak in languages of other people, and those who heard were convinced. Sometimes we as Christians, we bala in lies too much. But she spoke a language that someone had to say, I can find. Too many Christians speaking in lies, tongues of lies, and you cannot love your neighbor in English. I have you speaking talks of angels. Messed up church we have in this day. And pastor, we I'm not yet a pastor today, by the way. So many rebuked him and told him to be quiet. How can you tell me to be quiet? Do you know why my name is Son of Honor and dishonor? I tell him to shut up. Listen, some of you, listen. Tonight, I beg you in God's name. When you go back to your Facebook, delete some contacts. I beg you. Go to your phone contact and delete some names. Because as you see that name, they're telling you to shut up. Listen, we pray some funny prayers sometimes, you know. We cast and bind demons in our villages, fight some demons in our sin cards. Monitoring, you take your phone wherever you go now, right? Monitoring your movement. You put it on, listen, I know this thing, so I am Benin. I'm a Benin man. I know how demons work. Do not underestimate demons. Okay. Maybe the Lord will take you to Benin's commission. But the man rebuked him, but he shouted, oh, the man had told him, shut up. How can you call the Messiah? He shouted him up. They told him, how can you preach to a woman? She preached him up. They told him, how can you prophesy? She prophesied him up. They told him, how can you go further? She went further him up. The church is telling the women to stop shouting, to stop prophesying, but you know, do it yet the law. Church knew what the woman was, the woman that she is a helpmeet. She helped the church meet.
Hallelujah. Come on now.
Any church that rejects a woman, look how they are. They are adamants, no spirit of God. And all that speak in the church functions the choir because they have good voices. To make matter worse. Even the choir has become so out of God. And the only way the pastor can put you in the mood, he begins to tell the pianist to play softly. So you become emotional. And once the things worse more, they now put light effect in church to make you feel sleepy. To make things even worse, you now have motivational speaking on Sundays. When God is not glorified, it's all Adamas, no Adam. And God, guess what God is doing in this season? It's about, this is overturning tables. God was saying, when this referendum, referendum. Listen, honestly, logically, it might make sense to you. But this country is messed up. And if God wants to use a nation, the first thing he does, if God wants to use the man, he separates the man. God separates to prepare.
Yes.
So there are certain European laws that are in place. The revival, listen, some of you don't know that the prayers you are praying for revival for this land, that's what happened a few days ago. God has to separate us from the father, from the enemy, to begin to perform something in this nation. How do you tell me that you can support homosexuality?
Stood still for a man and said, call me.
Listen, if you have not received some king, the king of kings called a nobody. I tell you every time, God doesn't call the qualified. He qualifies the called. When I started ministry at a very young age, I started pastoring at 17, or did at 17. Started pastoring in the church at about 19 years old, about 3,000 membership in Port Harcourt, Nigeria back in the day. At 17, ordained as a pastor. At 19 ordained as a pastor. At 21, ordained commissioned as a prophet. Now, I have lived life in church. My parents are not leaders of church. They don't even go to church every once in a while. But I knew there was a call on my life. I did everything I could do to be known. I've gone to study. Someone was asking, how come you don't have a doctorate? You study up to your doctorate. Because sometimes, this tie to something make us feel like we are gods. And because sometimes we depend on our title and our mantle, we begin to fall and dysfunction. I was saying to God, Lord, you've called them to me and said, what signs do you have for me? One of the things that a lot of people call me sometimes, well, most of the time, is that when they try to elevate that prophetic. Let me tell you who your prophet is, just on the side. A prophet is not someone who tells you your house number. Diviners can do that. A prophet is not someone who tells you how much you have in your bank account. Even Thibaut knew Jesus was Lord.
Yes.
Jesus is Lord.
Yes.
A prophet is someone who tells you what happens tomorrow or what happened yesterday. Though you have the gift of the word of knowledge and the word of wisdom. A prophet is someone who tells you what you need to know from his word.
Yes.
Abraham was called a prophet, he never prophesied. John the Baptist was called the greatest of all prophets, he never saw a vision. A prophet is someone who tells you when God says speak. And sometimes two prophets can give false prophecies. Because you church have made us feel like we are gods. And when God is not speaking to us because he made us feel like we are gods, we fabricate lies. That is the problem of the church. You have respected and referenced prophets to a point where you cannot divide a prophet from a servant of God. And because you want a prophetic word to come from him, I have no choice but to lie when God is not speaking. Therefore, we have enough of the problem of the church is so many true prophets giving wrong prophecies. Why? Because you have made them gods. I was in Florida a couple of months ago. And the church was a massive church, and Prophet Oscar is around. And I never wanted to disappoint the pastor because he's my very good friend. I said to him, say, man of God, just give as God gives you. And I was ready. The Lord said to me, son, there will be prophetic word. When the Lord told me, son, because I am flesh, I stopped studying. I said, Lord God, I said, God, they will open my eyes to see things. And I stood before God's people, and I had preached. The atmosphere was charged. Time to give prophetic word. People are raising up waiting for a word. I began to battle. All I saw was pitch black. I could not. I remember the man of God came to me and said to my ears, Prof, what's happening? I said, man of God, pitch black. And guess what the man of God said to me? He said, just tell him something. You know why? Because if there's no prophetic word that comes from a man of God, people will be disappointed.
What? Shouldn't
he? Then I said to him, the day I begin to commercialize, the day I begin to say what God has not said, the day I lose this call.
Yes.
I'd rather displace 2,000 people that come before God than to displace God and cry later. As a man of God, I said to them, people of God have got to know what for you, what prophetic word for you today. And guess what the church did? The church stood there and they looked at me. And as I declared that word, as the man of God was saying, let's share the grace and go, then the Lord began to give words. Why? Because the Lord tested my faith in that city. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. Sometimes God will tell you, do not use the escalator. Use the staircase, not because he wants to punish you, but because he wants to know whether your obedience to him is greater than your word for him. Are you following me? A lot of times when I stop me, the truth says, your God says to me, so don't use this escalator, use this circuit. Why are you doing this to me, Lord God? And the Lord will tell me, because I want to know whether your obedience to me is greater than the love for the pleasure. You think I was going around cutting the ticket when God said to Abraham, take your son. Most of you want to change your name. The distance between your Abraham to your Abraham is your obedience.
Yes.
Listen, Abraham.
Hi.
Abraham is not the father of Isaac.
Hi.
That's right.
Abraham is or was. Abraham did not pass the test. Abraham did. The seed of your Isaac is in the womb of your next level. Some of you are trying to conceive with your Abraham and Sarah. God is saying no. Not the word Abraham means father of a high place. But for God to beg for a laughter, God and Isaac, God has to put an A-H to Abraham, an A-H to Sarah. And in the Hebrew terminology, A-H and A-H is God, ha-ha. And ha-ha means laughter. The reason why Isaac was begged for laughter was because of the process that Abraham had to go through. You cannot beg for a new age in an old season.
Yeah.
And the Bible says, amen, the Bible says, called the blind man. Now, they call him blind man, even though he said it was Bartimaeus. Does that make sense to you? Son of honor, but he was called a name that was his situation. Do you know that sister, that tall, fair sister that's looking for fruit of the womb? Do you know that brother, that one that has the brown shoe? Do you know that auntie, yeah, the one that drives that guy, yeah. They knew this man by situation. Does that look like you? They called him name because of the pity coming from going through. No longer was he called Bartimaeus, son of honor, because it doesn't look like honor. They called him his status, that blind that they called the blind man. But God will change your status tonight. Behold, he will do a new thing. And listen, you will see with your eyes. You will not be told, you will see with your eyes, and with your ears you will hear. And the Bible says they called him. Shut up! Listen, the same people who told him to shut up, now they're telling him to shut up. When God calls you, those who told him to shut up will tell you to shut up. And this man had his garments that was known for begging. beautiful garment. What is your Jericho? Poverty garments. And I'm like, oh, I mean, if I have more, I'm running off right by the way. And I'm poverty garments. And I'm fruit of the womb garments. And the pressure. I hear the word of pressure is leading somebody tonight. In the name of Jesus. I want to hear the word. No, no, pause to call it. You will come and testify. It's a woman. You feel weakness all over your waist. It's like your bones are weak. You will testify. I tell you. God is giving you healing. I'm saying about 2:15 a.m. tonight. God. Well, it's not tonight. Tomorrow morning, 2:15 a.m. Your blood will flow. Your blood has congealed. A sudden spot, it will flow. If you will testify. One more thing to somebody as well. This might not sound good. I love you. You love your church. But God wants to reposition you for another assignment. Thank God. Stop putting sentiment in your call. God is saying that He wants to reposition your assignment in your local church now. I want to give you a future, another assignment, but you are holding on because you are thinking, what will daddy say? I've just said, Mama, now. God is saying your next level is your obedience. God is calling you where you are and saying there's a new assignment for you, but you are telling us what's the sentiment. You and God have that one to deal with. Throne is broken. One of the things in our prayer service is garments. Amen. The only prayer I'll pray with you to do, maybe two prayers, is number one, your garment. Your garment is your representation. It represents you. When a man sees you, he sizes you based on your garment. It looks at that. Well, in this part of the country, well, you can be a millionaire and wear your t-shirt. Where we come from in Africa, a big man is standing behind dresses. And he saw this garment. The Bible said, he threw his garment and jumped on his feet and came to Jesus. But the question I want to ask you is this. Was he still blind? He was blind. Yeah, cars have not hit him yet. He was still blind, but they came to Jesus. He was still in his blind spot. He heard Jesus. They told him, come to him. Maybe they brought him to Jesus. But he came to Jesus the way he was.
Yes.
Listen.
Yes.
We do not come to church born again Christian.
Yes.
We come to God the way we are.
Yes.
That he transforms us. The problem we have in today's church is that we try to make people come to God saved. He came as a sinner, the way he was. Blind eyes he could not see, but he was standing before the King of Kings. The Bible said, he came to Jesus in verse 51. What do you want me to do for you? Jesus asked him.
Yes.
Praise God. Praise God.
Amen.
One of the women who gave us tea for our wedding day, she's charged money. And one of the things she did that I love, I'm praying for that woman. And I want to do it for me. Please do it for me. She gave us a blank check. No, not a blank check. Is it blank check you call it?
Yeah.
They'll tell you to put the amount you want.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus. That was, I beg you, do it for me, please. It's good. All she did was sign her name. He said, well, whatever you want to put. I said, hey, you're telling me. My wife, she's a bit shy. Oh, no, aunt. I said, what's the answer? Yes. Oh, blank check. And she told us, well, you do it just once, but do whatever you want, put whatever you want to put. And I said, well, auntie, will it bounce? And she said to me, listen. She said to me, depending on your extravagance, it should bounce.
Hey!
Are you all born again here?
Yes.
So no one will love you tonight. So it's fine. And you know when you put the money that you want, this is the money that you put the money that you want because you know the person. You say, for this auntie and I live in Nigeria, I put the money that I wanted. And the money that I want, when I saw the money, I was smiling. That kind of blessing, Christ said to the man, what do you want?
Yeah.
When someone gives you money that is even more than almost 2 times your wedding expense, and when your wedding expense is going to be 40 grand and all that, almost 2 times, what do you want? It's that kind of God. What do maybe not children, he could have said anything. But said, what do you want with blank check? The Bible says, the blind man said that I want to see, because if I can see, I will have my brother's license. If I can see, I will see my fine girl. If I can see, I will get a seat for my job. If I can see, why? Because the eyes of a man is his destiny. Everyone read in the Bible, while all the time reading the book of Judges, we spent a little man called Samson. Why was that after Samson? Why? Why? His eyes.
Yes. Yes.
A man was said to be a deliverer became a grinder. Why? Because his eyes are plucked out. If the devil wants to distract you from your mission, he takes your vision. It blinds you because you cannot leave the blind being blind. God, Jesus said, no, God just said, your faith has healed you. Immediately, he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. This is amazing. The Bible would have ended well if it said, immediately he received his sight. Remember, Jesus entered Jericho. He didn't stay in Jericho. This man was at the exit of Jericho. So if the Bible has said immediately received the sight, maybe he would have gone back to Jericho inside proper. But he received the sight and followed Jesus. The reason why God hasn't given you the money you pray for is because if he gives and blesses you with the money, he will not follow you. He knows. He knows. Because you are your point of desperation. When you are your Jericho, you are crying out, God, if I give this woman a man, he will just use themselves. You know, I was saying to the reason you cannot marry. But without respect, I don't like speaking in parable. Yeah, I like saying the word as it is. It will offend you, but it's direct. Yeah, I don't like saying, well, God has not made. No, the reason why you're not married is because each man God has brought to you, you test the water before you close the ring. How do you expect to get married to a man who sleeps with you? He's eating it. There's no surprise for him again. You just prayed and answered your prayers. This is why God cannot give you money, because he's giving you small, you misuse money management zero. And you're praying for financial blessing. You're praying for Lord God for fruit of the womb, but God gave you another child. If God gave you the first child, you're not home for the child. You're working 5 jobs. Bad time for your child. All you do is pay for child minder. All through the child grew up to 5 years old, never seen a small month full day. And you say, God, I need another fruit of the womb. One of the ladies at church came to us and said, pray for me, and I said, I've known you for 2 years, I've never seen you and your child play together for 1 minute, always working. God cannot trust you with the small he has. How will he give you more? So this man had this blessing from God. Instead of going back into the world and saying, I can see now, I need all the more gifts than for it. He says, no. He turned and followed the master. Listen, just 1-2 prayer points, I'm done for you tonight. I want to say to you, number one, you will not lose the property. No, this is for somebody, not for everybody. There's someone that wants to lose the property. I think they're giving it, it's a Thursday, you're going to lose, well, you are meant to lose the property. Or you will lose the property if you don't do what I said to you. You will get a letter on a Thursday, or whatever, I don't know how to do losing property in this country. That you're going to lose the property, you get a letter on a Thursday. The thing you need to do, take a pound. I'm not telling you 10 pounds. Take a pound. Obedience is better than sacrifice. God was saying to Saul, I don't need the fat king, the fat lambs, and fat forever. All I need is slaves. Take a pound. It looks like ritual. Take a pound. Speak to the pound. Speak to the pound. Say, Lord, you're giving. And don't go and give to a church. Are you following me?
Yes.
I'm just telling you what I'm getting now. Don't go and put it. Take a pound, no, it's a coin. Speak to the pound. If you cannot see those people begging on the road, keep it. When you see them, give them a pound. You will get this note on the first day. If you can do that, one pound, 1p. Just 1 pound. If you can do this, I don't know why God will do it. I don't know how he will do it. I don't know why he said to do it. But get a pound and give to someone who begs for money. Give the pound, pray for this and love God. As I give this pound, I take my keys to my property. I bless God for this. This is no powers of hell will take that from you.
Amen.
Are you following me? Then the second one. I know it's very hard to take it in when you have a problem in your household. When you have a problem with your husband, it's a woman here, I don't want to call you, I don't want to mention you now, your husband. Don't argue with him Saturday plus 4, Sunday morning, Tuesday, Wednesday, on Wednesday. Don't argue with him to a point that he leaves home between 10 p.m. and 12 midnight. Are you following me? It doesn't make sense, though. Don't argue with him to a point that he leaves home. He won't die. No accident. Nothing will happen. But guess what will happen? You have an issue. Your mouth, hold it for that time, hold it. He will say things that will annoy you. Instead of you to revolt, go on your knees, leave the room, go downstairs, cry it out, than to challenge him. Then guess what your husband will say? You're talking while I'm talking. He's African. You leave the house, drive his car, and it's a night you sleep out. And that night you will be a stepmom. Amen. I've said these two things. First thing first, you will not lose your property. Second thing first, if your husband shouts, I'm back, play the mungu. Play the zumbu. Keep quiet. Save your home. Swallow your pride. Let him sleep at night. Because when he shouts and he shouts back, boom, bangs the door. And next thing you see, 9 months later, we are news out. He has a child somewhere else. And he asks me, why did you do this? You don't fought with me. Praise God. Hands up on your feet. I just want to pray for I'm done. Father, we give you praise. Rati brash katu sad dirigo kami brash zada da oshikda. We give you praise because our sentences are changing. Rida santa le brahus shukda handa le besku. Rata le brashuta le brahida santa le brahus. Yata ibrashata le bosota ibrahashida. Lota we give you praise and le bosu ka ibrashada boska. Yita le brahus santa le brahuta le brashada bosuta. Rata ya magun sada da da magun sota le bora bosota ibrahada. Yete bosota da da magun tuzanda la bosa. Yete le bete bokusa da bokusa. Mana bosu kudu da da bosa. Yata ya da bosa da bo. Yana da da bosa da. Yata le bosa da ya brashada bosa. We give you praise and da da magun sada le da bosa. Yete le bokusa da 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 bokusa. Yere le like a blanket. And I'm seeing names on people's heads. I'm not calling names, I don't want to call names, but I think there's a name that's in my spirit. I hear the word Lord says is I don't know which of the speakers spoke on repositioning, but Lord says it's changing the status. I can't pronounce this name. I think I can spell it out if it's clear, it's a bit blurry at the moment, it's always starts with an O. I'm seeing the next one is G. Ah. Eve. And glory gives glory. The only one by the name there?
Yeah, that's my son.
Okay, glory. Come now. Blue. That's the color I saw, really. No light blue.
I like blue.
Come close. Do you tithe? Do you tithe in church?
No.
Do you give one tenth in church?
No.
No. Can you start giving one tenth? Do you believe in tithing?
I don't believe.
It's good you don't believe in the same truth. Like the blind man who took from the Lord blessed him and he followed. Before God and man. I don't know. You didn't know him before, sir?
Yeah, I've been to the one of the program before.
Do I know you? Have you met?
Yeah. I know you're not in a friendly manner.
Who, you're friends by the way anyway. Okay. He wants to trust you with financial, with finance, with business. He wants to trust you with money.
Yeah.
He's looking at me. I wish I was the one to have this privilege for myself. He wants to trust you with money, but he doesn't trust you with it. He said he doesn't trust you with your pride. Come. That's your wife.
Okay.
You tithe?
Tithe.
Abraham needed an AH on his name. Sarah needed an AH from Sarah. An AH, S-A-R-A-H, A-B-H-E-R-A-M and all that. For there to be a ha-ha laughter, there was an AH from both sides. I put my call on the line. If God doesn't bless you in 6 months, if you can be faithful for 6 months on your time, I put my call on God's line. This tag I don't believe in. Don't believe in it, but do it. Are you hearing me, brother? No, brother, sir. I see money in pounds coming out. It's spreading on you, but it's ending here. The money is literally, I see money falling like it was ending here. I'm asking God, why? Because this man is not faithful in his sanity. You are crying. I see God open doors and God says, I want to pray on you, but it's ending here. Can you do it?
Yeah!
Don't pay the tithe for him. If he doesn't pay the tithe with all due respect, I see under me, I'm not afraid to kneel down before God and say, God, ask on your behalf. If he doesn't pay, he stalks you all. You're all flesh and you're all married. You can't be praising, man of God, I saw £1 million rained on your head when you stopped here. And God said, he cannot trust you with money because you don't give him the little you have. And I'm begging you, I don't know you before, we've never spoken before. And Lord is saying to you, don't trust him with your side. And I give you just 6 months to do that. And Lord wants to rain blessing on you. And yet you deny God. You say, no, no, God does this. What is the chance to come in? What proof do you need to give that we got from God? Is that all your prayer for your financial breakthrough and freedom? You also bless you with plots of land. You also bless you with riches. Listen, you will sell lands in millions from here. I don't know how God is going to bring favor on your way. It was a call, a call. It's just a call that you hear from God. And the Lord will sweep you up and bless you and bless you and bless you. He will shout out for this is too much. If you can tithe, this cost you, it can be £10, it can be £5, it can be £1, it doesn't need to be millions, it can be £1 and more. Just because something is God. Sometime and it's all about within this financial stream. It could be networking, but it looks like it's networking. I don't know how financial stream. And you see a young woman. This young woman, the name is IT, well, not a young woman, maybe your age now, but looking at her way she's progressively growing, it's ITOHAN, you know. You see this person, ITOHAN. You know, it's a beginning, right? I don't have to speak, sorry. So, you see this person. This person will maybe through you or through your husband, but this person will give you a link. And with this link, I see a local government. This is not here. It is father and child. Oh my